they become the faces of Sheikh Jarrah.
Muna and Mohammed El-kurd, the poor Palestinians who are being expelled from their homes by the evil Zionist occupiers.
Or so they'd like you to think.
As it turns out, both of these hate mongers have made a career out of playing the victim and spreading their vehement hate anywhere they can.
And no, this isn't just criticism of Israel. Mohammed intentionally misleads, spreading fake news to incite real violence.
Like the time he shared a completely fake story with 10,000 retweets about an Israeli who stabbed a Palestinian 25 times with photos he said were too graphic to share.
Right, because they didn't exist. This story literally didn't happen.
But Mohammed doesn't care about spreading blood libels to his 200,000 followers.
After all, he explicitly condones violence, calling it resistance. That soldier with a stone in his fascist face, decolonization.
Really? Because I'm pretty sure decolonization isn't killing innocent people. But you know what is decolonization? An indigenous people returning to their homeland after 3,000 years in exile. Yeah, the Jews. And if you think that Mohammed's anti-Israel hate is just about Israel, think again. His social media is filled with anti-American hate too.
His twin sister Muna is no different. Here she's being praised by Fatah for being like her role model Dalal Mughrabi. Yeah, the woman on her phone cover. The same Dalal Mughrabi, a Palestinian terrorist who was responsible for killing 38 Israelis, including 13 children.
Muna's hate speech is so extreme that even the UN Human Rights Council recently kicked her out of a session for inappropriate behavior in which she called Prime Minister Netanyahu a terrorist.
Wow, ironic, considering that her role model is a child killer.
From exaggerated accusations of ethnic cleansing over their family's refusal to pay rent on a property they have never owned, to wildly overdramatic language referring to any Israeli as a settler, these twins have zero credibility when it comes to the facts on the ground.
While some of us are working to diffuse tension and come together as Arabs and Jews against violence, these two are doing exactly the opposite.